DZRJ 810 AM, the voice of the Philippines, proudly brings you Equal Justice. Find out the hottest legal issues of the week and hear the analysis. And now, here are your hosts, Attorney Ador Tolentino.
Yes to peace, no to PBS. Facebook.
Okay,
if you want to follow
me. Attorney June
Kichaw. Kailangan ano ba yun? Comfort level eh.
Exactly.
And Attorney Tiki Tabuhara.
Vice President Binay, pati si Pinoy, pati si Executive Secretary.
Chief. Alright, welcome back. And we have our special guest here in the studio, Pastor Roy Senyas.
Let me properly introduce our studio guest. He used to be the ambassador of United Arab Emirates during the time of the controversial Sara Balabagan controversy, and I think he was very instrumental in helping this young lady out of prison.
I do not know if the youth today remember Sara Balabagan.
I remember yung case
we were youth.
Because we're that youth.
And after that, when he came back from his foreign service posting, he was appointed chairman of the NLRC from 2002 to 2005, if I remember right. Okay, thereafter ventured into a lot of social
OFW
civic work that. Eventually, last 2010 elections, okay, he was elected as the congressman of the party list OFW
family.
OFW family. So let's welcome our guest, Ambassador Congressman Roy Senyas. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Privileged to be invited to this wonderful program of yours.
Welcome to the show, sir.
Welcome, sir.
And I hope this is not going to be the last time.
Actually, Ambassador Senyas, if I remember right,
yes,
has been our phone-in interviewee in one of our previous shows, because at the time his law partner, Attorney Paul Sangalan, was part of the show. If you remember right,
yes, I remember that.
Ambassador. Congressman.
Compañeros, you're all lawyers.
Yes.
I'm also a lawyer, by the way.
Oh, all right, okay. That's nice to know.
Yeah, because he was NLRC chair.
Yes.
And you can't be NLRC chair unless you're a lawyer. And now he is. Oh.
Anyway.
With me now, by the way, gentlemen, please allow me. With me now is Mr. Boston Sanchez, my general campaign manager.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Welcome to the studio.
Yes. Boston is actually a fellow retirement of mine. He used to be part of my club and now the president-elect of our daughter club, Sun Valley Sunrise.
Yes.
Welcome, Boston.
Yes.
Ambassador, you've been involved with a lot of labor issues throughout your career.
That's right.
You were involved with your OFWs and you were NLRC chairman. And I guess some issues that our listeners would like to know about is, for one thing, the issue, yung battle cry ninyo is contractualization endo. Diba yung
endo or 555.
Ayun. Yes. That seems to be your slogan right now. Congressman.
That's right. They're known as, otherwise known as the 555, because they're being laid off every 5 months.
Mm-hmm.
Masarap naman yung 555.
Yun ang gusto ko sabihin eh.
Magamat hindi sila pa, hindi pa sila sponsor dito, dapat mag-sponsor. But kahit na gaano ka-delicious yung 555, hindi dapat yan ginagamit na pangalan ng mga disente nating mga manggagawa. Ang gaganda ng mga sales crew, restaurant crew, diyan sa mga chain restaurants at sa mga giant malls.
Mm-hmm.
And yet they are being derisively called as the 555.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes endo. which means end of contract employees.
Congressman, I understand that this 555 practice of many establishments or the endo practice has actually been declared by the Supreme Court in a decided case that is illegal.
Yes, indeed. Before I go to the Supreme Court rulings on the matter of contractualization, please allow me first to cite the Constitution of the Philippines, which is already 41 years old. The Constitution says in its security of tenure clause, every worker in this country must have security of tenure.
Right.
In our own language, bawat manggagawa sa bansang ito ay dapat may katatagan sa trabaho. Anong klaseng katatagan? What kind of security of tenure are we talking of when they are being laid off every 5 months? That alone is already violative of the supreme law of the land, the Constitution. But unlike the political dynasty provision of the Constitution, the anti-contractualization, anti-security of tenure, the security of tenure clause of the Constitution has an enabling law. What is the enabling law? Article 280 of the Labor Code, which says that when the kind of job that you do for your employer is necessary or desirable to his business or trade,
right,
then you should be considered as regular.
That's right.
Even on day one that you have reported for work.
Yes.
Contracts to the contrary notwithstanding, the law says, Article 280. In other words, even if your employer, the giant malls, the chain restaurants, the factories, would require you to sign an employment contract that you're only good for 5 years, or 1 year, or 2 years, that is null and void from the very beginning because it is contrary to the Constitution and the law.
So how come these companies can do away with that? I mean, I can get away with that.
Before I answer you, sir.
Yeah.
I would like to, please allow me first to cite the relevant Supreme Court rulings concerning contractualization, which is unconstitutional and illegal. What did the Supreme Court say in the case of Shero versus NLRC? The court said contractualization is a deceitful agreement. Ang contractualization daw ay isang mapanlinlang na kasunduan, which is being used by selfish employers in this country to reap undeserved profits at the expense of their employees. Undeserved profits. You want me to show you the evidence of these undeserved profits? Some of these people who are now known as tycoons have already are already owners of airlines. and they're already in the Forbes list of the world's richest. Where in the world can you find businessmen from a third world country teetering between the third and fourth world, as a matter of fact, which is our country? Where in the world can you find this kind of businessmen landing in the Forbes list of dollar billionaires, rubbing elbows with Warren Buffet and Bill Gates? May nakita na ba kayo dyan sa Forbes list na yun, taga Bangladesh, taga Pakistan, taga Cambodia, taga Laos? Wala. Why? Because they have not yet discovered this thing known as contractualization. Another evidence of undeserved profits, while our fellow workers, and there are already 15 million contractuals in this country, according to statistics, well, they do not even have houses of their own. The employers who exploit and abuse them have so many condominium units already and investments not only here, but also in China and in Taiwan. Money coming from the sweat and tears and blood of our fellow workers being spirited out of this country to make businesses in other parts of the world. Money is the lifeblood of the economy, and if you bring out huge quantities of lifeblood from this country, you are causing a hemorrhage of lifeblood from the spending stream of our economy. Kung ano po yung pinapasok ng mga OFWs na mga remittances to the tune of $26 billion a year, wala yan. Kasi yung naghe-hemorrhage naman sa ating ekonomiya dahil dito sa mga negosyante, mga selfish, according to the Supreme Court, ay na baliwala din. Isa pang kaso, if you will allow me, is the case of Brent School versus Zamora. What did the highest court of the land say concerning contractualization? Contractualization mocks the law. Ang contractualization daw ay tinutuya, dinuduraan ang batas. At pangatlong case in, decision in point, yung kaso ng Magsalin and Coca-Cola Bottlers and the National Organization of Working Men. Ito, memorize ko na ito. Dahil chairman pa ako ng NLRC, alam ko na itong kaso na ito. What did the Supreme Court say? Speaking through Mr. Justice Jose Bito. Dumaan siguro kayo dyan.
Dumaan yung libro.
Speaking through Mr. Justice Jose Bito, what did the Supreme Court say? Contractualization demonstrates the serious problem of impoverishment of so many of our people and the resulting unevenness between labor and capital. Unevenness, the distance, the gap, the chasm between the rich and the poor in this country continues to widen. Why? Basically, essentially, due to massive contractualization in the entire country.
Yeah. Okay, so
back to that question.
Yes. So my question is,
with all this
having established that, in our constitution and in our jurisprudence, how come these companies still get away
with contractualization? Na nakakawala pa sila.
Yes.
For instance, in 2013, there was a candidate, A. I love name names. I respect these people because they happen to be my friends. There was candidate A in 2010. Candidate B, presidential candidate C and D. Okay? Where did they get the money to subsidize their presidential campaign? Where did they borrow helicopters and small aircraft to be able to go around the country and campaign? The answer is quite obvious, needless to say, from the typhoons.
Yeah.
The typhoons, the practitioners of contractualization in this country. Lahat yan binibigyan ng donasyon, lahat yan pinapahiram. Kaya pag nanalo, kung nakita nyo naman kung sino nanalo, pag may state visit, kasama si Don Jaime Sobel de Ayala, kapag may kinakasal na anak, kumpare siya, eh paano yung mga 15 million contract funds? Nasa Salaula.
Yeah.
Wala kasi, nabulag na ako, pinahiram kasi kami ng eroplano niya noon eh. Kaya we will not implement the law. And para hindi mahalata ng mga 50 million contractuals na yan, na sila ay nasasalaola natin dahil tayo ang mga bagong kasiki at you the lords ng bansang ito. Sa bagay, pag kinumbay mo yung square meters ng mga malls ko, mga restaurants, mas marami pa ng mga lupain, mga panahon na ng mga praile. Diba? So, yun. Kapag nanalo, isa man dyan sa FINAFAN na yan, goodbye. Anti-contractualization law. At meron pang mind conditioning na ginawa. Meron daw batas na si Senator Herrera ang nagpasa. Legalizing contractualization. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear compañeros, show me that law and I will no longer continue running for president. I will withdraw. I am very, very positive and sure about it because there is no such thing as the Herrera Law. Kung sino mang maniniwala ng Herrera Law na yan, nagpadala kayo sa mind conditioning at brainwashing nitong sabwatang mga taong gobyerno at itong mga malalaking mga negosyanteng nagpapairal nitong deceitful agreement.
Okay. Just for the benefit of our listeners, no, itong contractual, is it the same as casual? Yung casual?
Ganito.
Ating casual na yan.
Thank you very much, sir, for asking that. Yung Article 280 na binabanggit ko, sinasabi dyan eh, when the kind of job that you do for your employer is necessary or desirable to his business or trade, then you should be considered as regular, even on day one that you have reported for work. Exceptions, casual employment. Ano ibig sabihin ng casual employment? May restaurant si Boston, yung general campaign manager ko halimbawa. Tumulo ang bubong, eh nababasa yung ulam ng mga customer niya. Napatawag siya ng karpintero. The job may be necessary to the business. But
that's desirable.
But it is only casual employment. Kasi pag na-plug na yung leaf sa bubong, tapos goodbye na. Ka na, casual lang. Another exception is project employees.
Yes.
Yung contractor, construction company, eh nakakuha ng kontrata, nagumuha ng building, itapos na yung building. So ano magagawin mo dyan sa maso na yan? At saka sa mga karpintero, alam nga naman pensionado sino kahit wala nang ginagawa. Another example is seasonal employment. Halimbawa yung pineapple company. Pineapple company. Planting season of pineapple or banana. Eh, kinuha kita. Kinuha kita, 100 kayo o 1,000. Eh, pagkatapos ng planting season, goodbye.
Wala nang trabaho.
Balik na lang kayo pag-harvesting na. So, yun ang mga exceptions. Another exception is probationary employment, which should be approved by the Department of Labor, which should not be over 6 months. Kapag pinatrabaho mo yan, over 6 months, regular yan, kahit wala nang panibagong kontrata. For 3 months as the case may be.
So apparently, these people, these so-called contractual employees, are being hired as probationary employees.
No, because...
Not necessarily.
Because some of them have been working with this giant boss already for 10 years.
Yeah.
So they are not probationary because how can you put people on probation for 10 years? You can put people on probation with the approval of the Department of Labor only for a maximum of 6 months.
Bakit wala nagdidemanda? I mean,
actually, I wanted to ask the same question, Judy. Bakit itong mga big na simples natin? Di ba may mga magaganda mga sales girls, di ba? Bata pa, walang matanda. O konti na matanda, except yung supervisor. Ang pagkaintindi ko dyan, because my maid was a former sales girl also, ang sabi niya, 6 months lang daw siya, and then after that, she will be discharged, and then ibang grupo na naman ang papasok.
By batch na yan eh, by batch.
But there was no indication na hindi siya nag-qualify as per the standards of the company. So she was doing a good job,
yes.
And yet, in-endo siya. So, yan ba, sir, valid ba yun?
Hindi ako valid kasi ang ating saligang batas na nagsasabi na security of tenure. As a matter of fact, may Supreme Court ruling na nagsasabi that if you are a worker in this country, you may consider your job as property.
Yes.
Because you are securing your job. You may not be terminated unless there is a just cause on the part of the employer to terminate you. Example, serious misconduct. Number two, gross and unusual neglect of duties and willful breach of trust and attempt upon the life of the employer. Take note, serious misconduct. Kahit na misconduct yan, kung hindi serious, hindi ka pwede tanggalin.
Pero bakit wala
That's how protective the law is.
Yeah,
but pero yung sasabihin, sir, na itong grupo na to, after 6 months, kukuha na tayo ng panibago, mga bata na, kasi yung iba nag-asawa na, nagbuntis na. Is that valid?
It's not. Because why are they being terminated? Because a so-called contract, they are only good for 5 or 6 months. There is no just cause. Have they committed serious misconduct? Have they committed willful breach of trust? Or gross and habitual neglect? No! They are good workers! But they signed a contract. And dahil sa kontrata na yan, goodbye.
Yeah, but that contract is supposed to be invalid.
Invalid, yes. Unconstitutional,
yes. And therefore,
unrighteous.
They can always go to the to Dole,
yes,
to file cases. Why are there no you know, litigants?
No, there are.
There are.
Marami-rami rin
yan. That's why I cited to you some cases already.
Yeah, but...
But you know, this NLRC, of which I was chairman for 5 years, can only decide on this matter on a case-to-case basis.
Yes.
The NLRC, no, the NLRC cannot do a sweeping a legislation, because it is not a part of the legislative branch of this country anyway, to declare and to direct the selfish employers to obey the law.
Yeah.
They can only order insofar as the
particular
case file ready. In other words, why am I running for president?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why don't I just remain as congressman or senator?
Mm-hmm.
Are you gonna have a break?
Okay, congressman. Before we pause for a break, I just want to make this comment, and later on we want your take on it. Maybe the reason why this happens, despite all these prohibitions in the constitution and existing laws and our present jurisprudence on the matter, is because the workers simply don't have any other choice. Because as we know, you give them something where they can earn little money, they would grab it, because there's no other choice. So before you comment on that, let's pause for a very short break.